has been a presentation of ABC Sports, recognized around the world as the leader in sports television.
A promotional fee has been paid by Northwest Airlines, finding new ways to serve you for more than 60 years.
Some people just know how to fly.
Of all the gifts you can give a child, nothing gives more than a little of your time.
My special friend taught me all kinds of things.
Sometimes all it takes is one person to forever change the life of a child in need.
A lot of kids out there need a person who they can look up to.
You could be that person.
When you know someone needs you, you feel much better.
So look around, make some calls, but please find a way to connect with a kid who needs you. It's time to put children first.
Monday, the question every man fears.
How do we feel about our sex lives?
An all-new comes with the shocking S-word.
Stagnating.
Stagnating?
Not in a bad way.
Stagnating means rotten and smelly.
Then, Corbin Burnson's a ladies' man.
Don't touch that!
He's a real smooth operator. It's an all-new, whole new ballgame after comes. Monday, here on ABC.
The North Carolina School of the Arts is coming to town looking for talented ballet dancers. Auditions will be held January 24th at Baldwin Junior High from 4 to 6. If you've moved to Montgomery recently and are female, sorry guys, the Newcomers Club of Montgomery invites you to a luncheon and program on Thursday, January 26th. And down south in Coffee County, the Arts Alliance presents the revolutionary Mrs. Adams on January 21st. You gotta see it, and I'm Kim Davis, and I gotta go.
Gulf Coast Electronics, Subway, and Woe TV are giving you a chance to win big during Super Bowl 29 with the big return. Here's how to play. Register at Gulf Coast Electronics, Woe TV, or any participating Subway. Then, watch Super Bowl 29 and see if you're a winner. 10 lucky winners will receive Super Bowl prize packs. And if you're one of the two grand prize winners and a punter kickoff is returned for a touchdown, you'll win a big screen TV. The big return, only from Gulf Coast Electronics, Subway, and your Super Bowl station, Woe TV.
On the next Baywatch, a riptide in the romance.
I'm not working with him, and that's all there is to it.
Crashes in on Stephanie's sister.
Logan dumps me, and I'm still incredibly attracted to him. I mean, I don't get it.
Now, will Caroline's first day on the job...
I was watching Logan. That's why I missed the rescue.
...be Logan's last.
Your sister misses a rescue, and I get transferred for breaking up with her? Well, he won't get away with it.
On the next Baywatch.
Saturday on Woe TV.
Sports biggest show, January 29th on ABC.
The following is a special presentation of ABC Sports.
Welcome, everyone, to the Beardees Memorial Coliseum on the campus of Auburn University, where today ABC's college basketball prevents the high-octane Hogs out of Fayetteville, Arkansas, as they take on the hometown Auburn Tigers. Good afternoon, everybody. Mark Jones in the house along with Terry Gannon. Welcome to the eighth run ever between these two teams. And, Terry, when you think about Arkansas, you think about the defending national champions, but sometimes... heavy is the head that wears the crown.
Expectations, they're a heavy burden, especially when you win the national championship. All Arkansas has done is go 13-2 to start the year. They won 11 in a row at one point. Everybody's on their back, but Nolan Richardson expected that. Mark, what they haven't done is really put it all together like they did at the end of last year. They haven't been dominant. The bench hasn't really been there. Hasn't been 40 minutes every game. I mean, 25 minutes or 30 minutes when they create that pressure and the turnovers. They're just searching for the chemistry. I think they'll be fine at the end of the year.
Speaking of chemistry, right here at Auburn, hey, coming to the game this morning, 2 hours before the tip-off, we saw a huge lineup of fans. Cliff Ellis has created a lot of excitement here, hasn't he?
They were giving nothing away either, which doesn't happen usually in basketball. Cliff Ellis has really created a lot of excitement his first year after being at Clemson. He's already brought in a starting point guard, too. Moochie Norris out of Odessa Junior College in Texas. Normally, first-year players don't take over the leadership role. He has done just that. But today, against Arkansas, he's got to have a great game handling the basketball.
Here's a look at the SEC's Western Division standings. Arkansas at 2-1. They were tripped up against Ole Miss. Meanwhile, Auburn is 1-2. And like I said, it's the eighth meeting ever between these two squads. Nolan Richardson's team trying to repeat as national champs. We'll be back with the opening tip right after this.
There's a whole new spirit at Pizza Hut. That's why from now on, your pizza will be right or it's free. Guaranteed.
My husband and I both work. But when there's a problem with the kids or around the home, I'm usually the one to deal with it. But it's not just me they depend on. It's my income, too. If anything ever happened to me, State Farm can help make sure their future is secure. If you want to talk life insurance with somebody who knows what they're talking about and knows how to listen, talk to a State Farm agent.
And like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Mark Jones along with Terry Gannon. Let's meet the defending national champions from Arkansas. Clint McDaniel is making his first start after missing two games and playing sparingly in the last game a couple of days ago. Meanwhile, Corliss Williamson, the team's leading scorer. The head coach, Nolan Richardson, in his 10th season at Arkansas, still trying to get his team to the point where they can play where he wants them to play. Meanwhile, Auburn's starting lineup features two forwards and three guards this afternoon. Chris Davis replacing Pat Burke in the starting lineup. Burke, the 6'10" postman. Cliff Ellis, meanwhile, as we mentioned earlier, in his first season at Auburn with a record of 8-4, off to their best start in 7 years. And Terry, look at some of the keys to today's ballgame.
We mentioned Moochie Norris, and as the point guard, he's got to handle the pressure today. You know, whenever you play Arkansas, they're going to come after you. Maybe not for 40 minutes now, but they'll trap you on the half court, on the full court. They've got to take care of the basketball at home. And for Arkansas, they just got to play with emotion, Mark. That's one of the things that turns it around. I mean, they're playing well, don't get me wrong, but they do have two losses. Expectations are so high. Enthusiasm and emotion, the things that really kick it in for a team.
And Nolan Richardson was mentioning that the team is still trying to get its legs back after that long trip out to Hawaii. Razorbacks at 13-2, Auburn at 8-4. A win here for the Tigers would be a huge notch in their collective belts, and they win the opening tip. Here's Norris. Arkansas showing their man-to-man defense. Davis in the starting lineup today misses his first attempt.
And here come the Razorbacks averaging over 91 points per game. Highest scoring team in the SEC. As always, we love to run it up.
Thurman misses the reverse, and Norris comes back the other way. Early in Auburn's game against LSU a couple of days ago, both teams shot the three effectively, especially Auburn, especially this man with the ball right now, Lance Reeves.
A little bit of a matchup right now. They're switching on the screens inside, and as a cutter goes through, so it's not really a man-to-man that Arkansas is playing.
Davis out of control. Loose ball. Stewart couldn't get a hold of it.
And it's a jump ball situation, the arrow in possession for the Razorbacks.
Mark, when you look at Auburn's lineup, they've had eight different starting lineups in the first 12 games, now the first 13 games for Cliff Ellis, and a small lineup. They're not a big team. Inside, there's no question Arkansas has the edge today. They'll try to pound it inside and get some paint points with Williamson inside and maybe get Stewart off a little bit in this game. He hadn't scored all that much. Defensively, Auburn's going to have to try some different defenses, and here they come with a half-court trap right away.
It's something that was effective early in the game against LSU. The big nasty fouled underneath, and he'll get two at the charity stripe. Lance Weems, the culprit.
You got Corliss Williamson at 6'7", 245, 250 against Lance Weems, 6'2", 185 pounds. Guess who's going to win that battle?
That is the picture of a mismatch.
And they beat the pressure very nicely. You know, a couple of dribbles, that's it. Two passes inside. You got Weems trying to defend Williamson. He's going to the line. But teams, though, are fouling Williamson. He hasn't shot the ball well from the line. He hits his first one. He's only shooting about 61% from the line. Go ahead and foul him. Send him to the free throw line.
A part of his game that he's been working on a lot lately. Still trying to show results from that extra time in practice. Williamson makes the first of two, makes both. And the Hogs with a 2-0 lead early underway here in Auburn.
And a little bit of pressure up court from Arkansas right now. They're really not playing the way they did at the end of last year. The bench, the depth really hasn't come about, so they can't really go for 40 minutes of full court pressure.
Underneath, Williams foul, trying to go up the second time. Franklin Williams, a 6'5" Redmond redshirt freshman, underneath, got two cracks at it, but couldn't convert.
Strong player, too. That's why Cliff Ellis loves to see him in there. Williamson comes down with the body, and they call it before he went up in the air. I thought he was shooting.
Clint McDaniel back in the starting lineup for the Hogs at the top of that zone. Flanagan from downtown. Boy, Auburn coming out ice cold in the early going. They have yet to make a field goal. They have yet to score. Dwight Stewart. And he misses. Both players thought about it, and now Weems fires, no good.
That's a shot he's got to knock down. He's out there to shoot the basketball, and against that defense, you have to bring him out and play.
Weems made 7 three-pointers against LSU in their last outing. Williamson inside, no good.
Didn't get it, but how about a quick first step? A drop step in the middle.
Here's Weems.
You know, most people talk about playing Arkansas and controlling the tempo of the game, but controlling tempo doesn't necessarily mean you don't run. You have to take your opportunities because they're so tough in that half-court defense, especially with the height differential today. Good, easy bucket as Weem gets ahead, and then he gets the foul as well, so maybe a three.
Take the easy ones when you can get them. Weem shooting 81% from the foul line as they put on their 1-2-1-1 full court press. Easily broken by the Razorbacks. Stewart on the offensive foul. That's his second of the ball game.
Two trips up the court, two fouls on Dwight Stewart. So we'll see what Nolan Richardson does with Dwight Stewart. Does he send him to the bench or does he let him play with two? That is no question. I think he was there. Dwight created the contact.
Stewart, a guy who's 6'9", but who can put it on the floor and, for his size, shoots the ball very well from the perimeter. Weems for three.
Can't give him that one all day. The all-time leading high school scorer in the history of Alabama.
McDaniel back the other way, back at you for three. Clint McDaniel is a better shooter, Terry, than most people think.
You know, he had the first year off because of the SAT scores and academics, and he was eligible and came about. That may have hurt him for a while. Shoot the ball much better.
And now we have a three-point shooting contest as Mucci Norris hits one. Arkansas down by four, and they turn it over. Terry, this is the type of early success that you would hope to have if you're an Auburn booster.
Well, the first 10 minutes of the game, there's no question that the Cliff Dwellers in the end zone, they want to see Auburn stay in this thing because I think the longer this one goes at home, the confidence grows. You know, late in the game, if it's a tight game, the tight sneakers are on the feet of the Arkansas Razorbacks.
Peck with the steal to Williamson. From the corner, Garrett got it.
Playing well. He started two games for McDaniel when he was out with the sprained foot. Shooting the ball well. Norris on his roller skates. Boy, he's got a nice handle. Williams inside, and he's fouled. If that's on Stewart, that's trouble. That could be his third. Well, you saw Dwight just stand there and try to look innocent after the foul was called. The foul is on Corey Beck, number 14, so it's not on Stewart. But Stewart sits down anyway, and in comes Darnell Robinson, a.k.a. Tank. As Franklin Williams steps to the line. Williams, a redshirt freshman, shooting 73% from the stripe.
And I mentioned Cliff Ellis just loves this young man. Sat out, learned a lot about playing on the perimeter after playing with his back to the basket in high school. And a lot of players have to make that adjustment. It's nice to have that redshirt year where you can play and practice against some pretty darn good players that they had here last year at Auburn.
Auburn almost coming up with a steal. The Razorbacks may have gotten away with a walk right there. Garrett, smooth as butter.
Boy, that's nice. Awfully hard to do. Stop on a dime after the fast break and not even use the glass.
Garrett now with 5 points in the ball game. Arkansas trailing by one. Williamson forced to play on the perimeter defensively. And the Razorbacks come up with a theft.
Tough to get that back door against a switching man-to-man with a matchup.
Side. Williamson had his man pinned in jail. Terry, if he gets the on his back, it's over.
Forget it. Run the other way. There's no way you're going to stop him. He was underneath the hoop.
Williamson now with 4 points in the ball game. Arkansas with the lead. Norris on a mismatch now.
Team uses quickness against Williamson. Oh, he had him in the air. He could have drawn the foul.
Inside to Williamson. It's a jump ball. The possession arrow favors Auburn this time. After 4.5 minutes, Richardson's team leading by one. We'll be right back.
Introducing the Toyota T100 Extra Cab. Its new 190 horsepower V6 actually out-accelerates V8s. It's big and spacious, yet amazingly maneuverable. And it's extremely rugged, yet incredibly refined. The new T100 Extra Cab. It's the Toyota of big trucks.
Look, a MasterCard won't make you different or unique, okay? Actually, maybe it will. I mean, millions of people use MasterCard, but yours is meant for you and you alone. So if someone steals it, instead of worrying about people running around pretending to be you, call right away and cancel it. Because, after all, there's only one you. What's more, even if somebody does manage to charge stuff to you, you won't pay a cent, and we may even be able to get you a new card the next day. But just for you. Now, how's that for a useful card? MasterCard, it's more than a credit card, it's smart money.
Tomorrow, Doug and Ann Porter will watch their only daughter walk down the aisle. The McDades will embark on a retirement journey to Scotland. And the Sweeneys will pack the last in a series off to college. Tomorrow, the dreams of many will be realized, thanks to a simple broker philosophy.
We must never rest in our commitment to the individual.
For those of us at Dean Witter, like Dave Rieger.
Dave, are you still working?
We measure success one investor at a time.
Christy Yamaguchi, Katarina Witt, and Midori Ito compete in the Fresh Look World Challenge of Champions. It's the season premiere of ABC's Wide World of Sports next Saturday.
Arkansas leading by one as we take a look at Cliff Ellis, the first-year head coach of the Auburn University Tigers. A look at the three-point shooting so far from the respective teams. Arkansas, 2 of 3. Auburn, 2 of 4. Arkansas, Terry, leads the conference in three-point field goal percentage.
42% they've shot on the year, which is tremendous. You know, but teams are afraid to go after them because of the athletes, because of the quickness that they've had.
And interestingly enough, as the ball goes out of bounds and will stay with the Tigers, Nolan Richardson was saying that they're not quite as quick as they were last year. I think from a bench standpoint, they haven't produced like they did last year. You talk about three-pointers, Lance Weems can bury him. If you're going to play the zone like Arkansas does out of the out-of-bounds, you got to make sure you get a hand up in that man's face.
Weems heating up quickly. He has 8 points so far, 8 out of Auburn's 14. He's the team's leading scorer at over 15 per. Williamson foiled inside, rebound to Beck. And they pound it back inside.
Got to get out of the lane, though, Mark. Once it goes in there, or shoot the basketball, and that's what we get. It's great.
Yeah. Almost overpassing. And I think that's what Richardson is telling his big man right now. Don't get too excited.
And Darnell Robinson had the shot inside. And now, with the big lineup in for Arkansas, Pat Burke comes in for Auburn to get a 6'10 man in there. It's Chris Davis, who got the start today. We'll go bigger lineup against bigger lineup.
Ellis perhaps seeing the trend for Arkansas going inside, trying to counter now with his big man, Pat Burke.
It's like a straight man-to-man now by Arkansas. Tougher for Weems to get his shot off. Oh, nice penetration, though.
Norris made that happen.
Hey, Mucci Norris created that three. There's no question.
Auburn down by, up by 5 points, 17 to 12. Weems was 7 of 10 from three-point territory against LSU two nights ago.
A battle going on inside.
Clint McDaniel. Rebound Auburn. Oh, Flanagan! Man, did he play peekaboo with that. First the steal, the strip by Weems, and the pass ahead. And what a move at the other end by Wes Flanagan in the air. Watch how it takes place. The miss and actually a rebound, but the quick hands of Lance Weems. He starts the outlet with a nice pass to Flanagan. And watch the up and under. No chance for Corey Beck to get him, and he creates the foul as well, and he goes to the free throw line. Auburn really playing confidently right now. They're at home, and it helps. And Cliff Ellis on the sideline doing some teaching, but they look like a team that expects to be in this game at the wire today.
Dale Brown said a few nights ago, the coach of LSU said that this Auburn team, Terry, plays harder than any team he's seen here in the last 20-odd years. And the effort bearing fruit right now as they lead 20-12.
With possession. Forced drawing board by Williams.
No reason to take that shot right now. You're going inside. You have success. They can't guard you in there. Pound it in the middle.
Williams got to get a hand up on him. This place would have lifted the roof up. They got it inside. Richardson calls for a timeout. The Tigers are roaring right now.
It is a world of spaciousness. It is Avalon. Extraordinary comfort that creates a serene environment. Engineering that virtually eliminates noise and vibration. Establishing a higher level of elegance than any Toyota ever. Avalon, the new flagship from Toyota. Experience the trend.
At BASF, we don't make the mattress, we make it softer. We don't make the boots, we make them drier. We don't make the house, we make it livelier. We don't make the snowboard, we make it stronger. At BASF, we don't make a lot of the products you buy, we make a lot of the products you buy better. BASF.
Mike Klein's been my State Farm agent for 9 years, and he's been a coach in the community for 3. He's as dedicated to those kids as he is to his policyholders. The most important thing that I can do right now in my life is to protect my family in the future. The way he handles my life insurance shows it's important to him, too. My other friends who have State Farm life insurance say the same thing about their agents. You know, I think there is something to this good neighbor business.
State Farm is there.
Disney presents one of its greatest adventures. You loved it growing up. Now share it with your kids. A Disney treasure, the ABC family movie, Swiss Family Robinson, Saturday.
Special promotions throughout the season.
The Auburn Tigers leading by a dozen. Cliff Ellis's crew out of the box quickly. They have made 8 of their last 9 field goals, Terry.
Nolan Richardson called the timeout, and during the timeout wanted to switch it to a 20-second, which is in effect in the SEC this year. You can't do that. You can only go from a 20 to a full. And another miss at the other end. Boy, look at the run. You wouldn't expect that to happen in this game. I mean, at some point, because of the inside strength, but they have just dominated so far.
And another foul against the Razorbacks. One thing that surprises me here early in the game, Terry, is that Nolan Richardson's squad hasn't handled the full court pressure as well as you would think they would.
Exactly. And with a team that won a national championship and faced every type of pressure you could imagine last year, same faces here. It's one of the things. Mark, you're the defending national champions, but it's a different year. It's a different team. And until you get that chemistry, that all-elusive chemistry, it's not the same.
Burke reeling inside. Rebound Thurman. Alex Dillard checking into the game for Arkansas. And it usually doesn't take him much time to heat up. He is the mini microwave.
Yeah, usually it's from about 20 feet, though. Not a layup.
Cuts the lead to 10. Norris with the ball out of Washington, D.C. You can usually note him by the high white socks and the floppy shorts.
Going against the grain nowadays.
Pass inside, and they turn it over. Burke walked with it. Boy, Arkansas breaking the pressure easily now. Dillard misses the layup, and it's interference. Dillard a little careless with that layup, Terry.
Used the one hand, didn't he? I thought he could have gone up strong. And Nolan Richardson now trying to set up his defense. They stayed in that matchup, that switching man-to-man. It looks like they're going to go back to a zone right now, though. So watch out for number 15, Lance Weems, trying to get in the seam and shoot another 3.
Weems in the corner, stepped out of bounds. Made the shot, but it will not count. There's a situation where you're so wide open, Terry, that you'd almost lose a place of where you are on the court.
To see the look on the face of Lance Weems, he buries the 3, and they take it away from him.
Jim Costner checking into the ballgame for Pat Burke, who takes a seat. Costner, a guy with size, 6'10", a senior. And Lee Wilson checking in for Corliss Williams. Maryland defeating Wake Forest by 10.
Arkansas handling the pressure pretty well. They had the one turnover against it, but at this all, what a nice move by Dillard. Just as I said, they haven't gotten great shots against the pressure, which you would expect. Williamson out now, and so they take it to the rack. Dillard, with his quickness, gets the bucket in the foul.
Al Dillard, a guy that has really come on, Terry, in the last 3 games for the Razorbacks. Started slowly this year, was shooting about 25% from 3-point land early in the season. They blame themselves for trying to do too much with his game to try to make him a more rounded player, but now he's back to being basically just a guy who comes in and gets on offense and scores.
Doesn't have to worry about everything else. They're just giving him the ball and saying, this is your role. Fire away at will.
Remind you of anyone, Terry?
That's a nice way to play, isn't it? Perpetual green light.
Approaching 11 minutes to play in the first half. Auburn leading 24-17, and they turn it over. That's the 5th turnover of the afternoon for the Tigers.
Surprised right now that Cliff Ellis has taken Weems out of the ballgame. He needed a rest, but against that zone, I would expect to see him back in right away.
Managing personnel is going to be so important today for Auburn. When you look at the numbers that Arkansas has, it's going to be important, you would think, for Cliff Ellis to try and match up in terms of numbers with Arkansas. Here they come on the break. Jesus! Mushroom cloud forming at the other end of the court as Davis nails Lee Wilson.
Well, you can feel it at the other end. First the slam, Chris Davis on the break, and yes, they do know where the cameras are these days. Check it out, right into your house, right into your living room. And then at the other end, though, he hustles back, he gets a piece of the man, but a piece of the wall, man, everything else, the floor, and he sends him to the free throw line. Arkansas, though, had a 3-on-1 mark. They didn't get the easy basket. And they missed the free throw.
Arkansas as a team not shooting well from the foul line this year, shooting only 66% as Weems checks into the ball game again. They're not booing, folks. They're saying moo, as in Moochie, as he takes a seat.
And 0 for 2,
missing both.
3-on-1 fast break. They go to the free throw line, get nothing out of it. Arkansas in that matchup zone. They trail 26-17. 10.5 minutes to play now in the first half. Chris Davis aggressive offensively. And that'll be offensive interference against Auburn. And encouraging Cliff Ellis on the sidelines is a foul now called against Weems. That's his second personal foul. Next Saturday, ABC Sports, beginning at 2:30 Eastern, 1:30 Central, will have regional action of Pizza Hut College Basketball. A whole slate of games followed by Wide World of Sports premiere for 1995. A great lineup of figure skating.
And Arkansas can't get the basketball in bounds. They're right in front of Nolan Richardson, so they do take the 20 this time. They have one per half, so they take the 20. And I like that rule. That's an experimental rule, and a couple of the conferences are using it. The Big Eight's using it, and the SEC is using it. Gives the coaches an option just to call a timeout. If you can't get it in bounds, talk it over a little bit and go back and play.
Following the lead of the pro ranks,
which is happening more and more these days.
Sure is. That's another thing I think I've seen in some of the games that I've watched this year, Terry. The college ranks taking and following the lead, actually, of the pros with respect to some of the hand-checking going on. See a lot more hand-checking fouls called in college ranks this year as opposed to last year. We haven't seen many called, though, today.
It's interesting, too, because some teams really hate that. Hey, you take the team that plays tough, aggressive, trapping defense, for example, the Cincinnati, for example, really a lot of hand checks, and it hurts them. I mean, that's a big adjustment to make. Even Arkansas, who likes to get after you, it's an adjustment you have to make in the first quarter of the year.
Al Dillard from Birmingham.
Well, does he have the green light?
Green light. That's a Visa gold card.
And he's shaking Nolan's hand when he's taking that shot.
Wow. Flanagan, Weems from three.
Butter. Mark, they can't stay in the zone because the guards for Auburn are creating that shot for Lance Weems. Little penetration. They draw, they dish. He's had easy three-point shots.
Roy Beck to Al Dillard. That's what Al Dillard does for this team. He's starting to heat up. He started off slow this year, but is now starting to find the range.
Well, you got to love it, too, from a shooter. Isn't that a mentality? I mean, he catches nothing but backboard from about 35, and then he buries one the next time down.
That's 16 points against Ole Miss a couple of days ago.
Watch number 15 here, Weems. He'll just try to get in the seam. He's not even moving that much.
Another three-pointer. Flanagan this year starting to look to score more, and it's paying off. Beck can score two, but it's strong. Foul against the Razorbacks.
And Nolan Richardson's going to go back to his bench. He's going to bring Corliss Williamson back in the ballgame. They've got to get an inside game going against Auburn. There's no way they can handle him in there.
Well, Terry, tonight a Disney classic on the ABC Family movie. You loved Swiss Family Robinson growing up. Now you can share it with your family. Then an all-new commish, Tony and his crew, all tonight on ABC.
Corliss back into the ball game. He got quite a long rest. And really, their inside game went south when he went out. See if they try to establish it at the other end the next time down.
Williamson, one half of that great scoring tandem. The other half, that man right there, Scotty Thurman. Conspicuous by his absence, Terry. He has taken only one shot and has not scored today.
Just haven't had much rhythm offensively. Right. Except for the shots that Dillard has taken, which he always takes with authority. He doesn't hesitate. They really haven't had much rhythm or balance to their offense.
Costner at the line makes the first of two. He's a 6'10 senior. Stewart with the rebound. Arkansas trails 33-20. A surprise brewing here in Auburn. Dillard's shot is tipped and short. Auburn with numbers.
Boy, they are really patient, but now they throw it away. Dillard. Flanagan with the board.
Good time to back it out. Good decision by Flanagan. Take some air out of it right now. It's gotten a little sloppy. You go up and down a few times. Go ahead and attack against the half-court defense.
Auburn in their motion. Flanagan with the drive-by. Gets it to go. Wes Flanagan has 10 in the ballgame, and Auburn leads 35-20.
Arkansas has got to get the basketball to Williamson this time down. Let him touch the ball.
Thurman, with only his second shot of the afternoon, converts and bangs down the three.
And the reason the defense never went out to guard him, you've got Thurman on one side along with Williamson. You have to take your choice as a defense. You can't guard the inside and the outside.
Quentin McDaniel now on Flanagan. That's a matchup to watch, Terry. Flanagan, the leading scorer for this Auburn squad with 10 so far.
And back to the man-to-man for Arkansas. The zone did not help them at all. The three-point shooting of Auburn kind of took them out of it.
Seven on the shot clock. Donald. Patience pays off for the Tigers.
Boy, they never rushed. They never hurried. Well-coached basketball team.
Oh, Dillard. If he makes one more of those, I'm out of here.
My gosh. You have got to be kidding me. That ball's wet when it comes down, right through the clouds.
Al Dillard with his second three-pointer of the afternoon. 37-26, an 11-point lead for the Auburn Tigers. A lot of excitement here in Auburn. Cliff Ellis creating a lot of anticipation here when it comes to the basketball team. Norris travels, and it comes back the other way to the Hogs. Cliff Ellis' team leading 37-26 with 6.5 to play in the first half.
When you're the eyes and ears of a million people, you can't let your stomach get in the way. So I carry Snickers.
Roasted peanuts, milk chocolate, caramel. Snickers satisfies.
Shake it, no dandruff. You've got Selsun Power. Brush it, no flakes. You've got Selsun Power with Selsun Blue. Doctors recommend it number one over all leading brands. Dandruff problem? No way. You've got Selsun Power.
Hi, I'm Jim Palmer for the Money Store. It's hard to believe, but people are charging more on their credit cards than ever before. Have you looked at the interest rates on your cards lately? When you consider that credit card loans aren't tax deductible, the effective rate is even higher. And the same is true for auto loans. So if you're a homeowner with high rate loans, isn't it time to refinance at the Money Store? You could consolidate your bills at a lower rate, and the interest is usually tax deductible. Call the Money Store at 1-800-LOAN-YES.
Onward and upward. The awards, the honors, the accolades for the Toyota Camry continue to rise. Driven by a powerful V6 engine, precision crafted to the highest standards, Camry has risen to become the gold standard. While its starting price hasn't risen at all, introducing the 1995 Toyota Camry, newly styled, refined, and headed for even greater heights.
Temple takes on conference rival UMass. Duke invades Florida State or other regional action. It's Pizza Hut College Basketball next Saturday on ABC.
Well, the other sport here on campus at Auburn University, of course, football. And we are joined now at the table by the head coach of the Auburn football team. Coach, congratulations on a fantastic season. And you got to be excited about the fact that next year Auburn is eligible for bowl play.
Well, that's right. We've had to play ball games without any kind of reward. Now that the probation is over, we're ready for bowl games. And there's some excitement. You can see it here in the basketball arena. There's some excitement and some enthusiasm going on at Auburn University.
Big recruiting weekend for you. Had some recruits here. Great game for them to see.
Well, we kind of plan it that way. We've got about 23 or 4 coming in for the Auburn-Arkansas game, and they've seen a great basketball game.
Things never change. That just comes out, doesn't it?
No, I'm sitting at the 50-yard line. That's all I know.
Coach, in contrast to football, basketball has a final champion at the end of the season. I know your feelings about a playoff format, but who would you have voted for number one this year?
I mean, again, I'm a football coach, and I hate to sit there and say, I'd have probably have deep down wished there was a split decision that both teams could have been recognized as champions because they were champions on the field. But you can't take anything away from Nebraska. By being in the bowl coalition or the bowl choices, they put themselves in the position to play the best opponent. Penn State, by joining the Big Ten, going to the Rose Bowl, they knew they put themselves in the position to possibly not play the very best team in the country. By doing that, they can't complain.
Coach, thanks a lot for joining us, and we look forward to seeing you on New Year's Day here on ABC
thanks
next
so much,
year. Playing.
Good
thanks
to see you. Take care.
DeVore Remonts hit a three-pointer for Arkansas. In the meantime and in between time, but Auburn leads 40-29. Remonts out of Croatia. Dwight Stewart back into the ball game with his foul troubles and all. Cashes in on the tray.
And all of a sudden, the shooting is heated up at both ends of the floor. Mucci Norris at the other end buries a long one as well. So this ball game going up and down a little more now. Norris with a killer crossover.
You know, we have not seen a whole lot of Mucci Norris. He came in from Odessa Junior College, but Cliff Ellis recruited him when he was at Clemson, came here and said, why don't you come to the campus, look around, maybe you'll like it. Great story as Mucci Norris grew up in a tough section of town in Washington, D.C., and has really used basketball to further his life.
Scotty Thurman, life outside the three-point line, misses. Auburn really pressing the action offensively, but they turn it over. A four-on-one. And they work it open inside and lose it.
That just can't happen. When you're on your game, when you're playing with intensity, that can't happen. And Norris makes them pay at the other end. 4-on-1 mark, and they come up empty.
Much to the bane of Nolan Richardson. Dwight Stewart. Now, don't be surprised by him making that three-pointer.
No.
He regularly likes to step out and hit that shot. He can make it. And the coach has taken off his jacket. He's starting to work up a real good lather.
And at the other end, you've got Mucci Norris on the break. Stops, pops, no one around him. He'll take that if they're going to give it to him. And a little bit of the Mucci shuffle. He had the full-blown shuffle against LSU the other night, but not so here today.
He promised me he was going to give us one today. I spoke with him during the shoot-around. And look at both teams on fire from three-point territory, especially Auburn.
Yeah, and especially against the zone, too. They drew Arkansas out of the zone. Razorbacks like to switch up their defenses. They've taken away that option.
Every game is a big game for Arkansas, 1994-95. They're on everybody's hit list.
Flanagan getting two cracks inside. I mean, Auburn just playing great basketball from the outside on the glass. They don't have the height advantage inside. Look at Burke battling for this way. Actually, it's Costner inside. That's a good matchup for Arkansas. They've got to get in the basketball. Here he is. Williamson steps out. Has a shot blocked.
The Tigers simply, Terry, out-hustling Arkansas. It's that simple. And the fans voice their collective appreciation.
This place has not been this loud. I've come here for the last three or four years doing games. And there's no question Dale Brown is right. There's more excitement here than I have ever heard.
Costner coming over the top against Williamson, and he gets called for the violation. Foul against the Tigers. Auburn with a 14-point lead. The face of the coach whose team is leading.
Every week, Pizza Hut talks to 50,000 people all across America.
Hello?
I want Pizza Hut.
I didn't know I had pizza.
Because we want to know what you think.
Delivery guy was right on time. I gave the green peppers to my sister, and it was just the right amount of cheese. I love pizza for breakfast. In fact, Dad likes pizza better than Mom's cooking.
After all, it's not our Pizza Hut. It's your Pizza Hut.
Call back anytime you want some advice.
You'll love the stuff we're made of.
Concept cars. Those gorgeous cars built for auto shows. Wouldn't it feel great if they built one for you? Someone has. The all-new 1995 Riviera. A
new world standard for structural integrity among prestige luxury coupes. Riviera by Buick. The concept car you can drive home.
Hi, may I help you?
Yeah, I need some shorts to play basketball.
Indoor or outdoor?
Outdoor.
Full court or half court?
Half, I guess.
Pick up our play. Shirts or skin?
Excuse me?
Day or night, home or away, team or one-on-one?
Is activewear becoming too specialized for you? Try Discus Athletic. Heavyweight sweats and tees. The activewear that's right for however you play. Discus Athletic. The way America plays.
Horse or pig?
Auburn with a 14-point bulge over Arkansas. Folks, there have only been 14 two-point field goals made in this ballgame. Earlier we said it was 50-35, but it's only 49. That last field goal converted by Mucci Norris was only a two and not a three. Here's Raymonds on the wing. Willis Williamson goes to the bench, and now they go inside to Stewart.
To me, Mark, that's what they should have been doing the entire first half. Now, you look at the lineups and the heights, and it's just clear that they have the advantage inside, and Auburn's beating them up and down the floor. They've got to get the ball to Batman, who's sitting on the bench, and to Stewart inside.
I was just going to ask you if you're surprised at the fact that they haven't gone inside and tried to exploit their height as much as you had thought they would.
On the other side of the coin, Auburn's done a nice job on the glass. Now they limit Arkansas to one shot offensively, and they've been able to beat him up the floor.
Under 2.5 minutes to play now in the half. Here's Norris, joined by Flanagan, Williams, Burke, and Donald.
Nice skip pass. Boy, that's just nice. A Mucci Norris with the court vision. He finds the open man, and he finds a shooter wide open.
Donald now has 8 points in the ball game. Inside to Tank, who's fouled. Don't forget, coming up at halftime, actually, we'll tell you about our lineup tonight on ABC, America's Funniest Home Videos. Then a great retrospective with All My Children's 25th anniversary special. Folks, you can see all of Erica's husbands. I think there have been maybe a dozen of them. Followed by Driving Miss Daisy, an award-winning film. But Terry, as we look at Darnell Robinson on the foul line, he has been a big project of Nolan Richardson's during the last week and a half, trying to get him untracked. He's been encouraging him in practice, but that time he missed two foul shots.
Yeah, and things just have not gone well at all for Arkansas. They missed two foul shots. Corey Becton with the foul trying to get the ball back. And no one's been very calm on the sideline. He's sweating a little bit. And I know under that collar he's a little bit hot, but he has not really torn into his ball. That's Corey Becton's foul, too. So a huge foul sends him to the bench with just under 2 minutes left in the half.
Corey Beck is the leader of this team. You can say what you want to about Corliss Williamson, but Beck's the guy that really makes that team go. McDaniel and Remotz now in the backcourt. Thurman, Stewart, and Robinson up front.
Nice ball fake, but he walked with it. And there's another man in Remotz who's really struggled this year. He's a shooter. He was there last year down the stretch for Nolan Richardson. Just hasn't clicked yet.
Yeah, I don't think, and that's why Nolan's so calm, I think, on the sideline. He's not going to panic with this team. He knows he's got experience. He knows he has the same players, almost all the same players that won a championship. He's been very patient.
The look on his face says, I'll just want to get into the locker room and get things squared away at halftime.
Foul out top on the drive by number 44, Franklin Williams. Williams, a 6'5", redshirt freshman out of Headland, Alabama. And folks, don't forget, coming up at halftime, a review of last year's Slamfest dunk competition
Last year's winner, Rob Moore. And this year's competition, get a look at that next week. Under 1.5 minutes to play in the first half, Auburn leading 53-35.
And so far they have done everything you can imagine offensively. I mean, the defense has been there, they've rebounded, but offensively they've gotten drives to the basket, second shots, three-point shots, everything.
Thurman brings it up and fires himself. Not a great shot, and Auburn will get possession. Terry, not a great decision when you bring it up 94 feet and fire it yourself.
I think you start to press a little bit. And right before the half, you try to get some back to go into the locker room with momentum. They just want to get to the locker room right now. I got to be honest. I am absolutely floored sitting here courtside. It's what has taken place in the first half.
You and a lot of other people. Norris doing a fine job of directing this Auburn team in the first half. You know what? If Pat Burke starts hitting shots like that, then you really might be in trouble if you're Arkansas.
Well, you know it's your day if you're Auburn. You're right.
Side, no good, rebound, Tigers. And now it's on the floor. Off of Flanagan, it'll go to the Hogs.
Look at the hustle, though. And a crowd on its feet appreciating the effort from the Auburn Tigers. A young club for Cliff Ellis that comes in, and he told us, he said, the one thing we do every day is play hard. And here's an example. There goes Mucci. He goes into the second row, takes a couple of people with him.
That's not the Mucci shuffle he was talking about either.
I don't believe so.
Mucci Norris out of Washington, D.C., grew up in the same apartment building and complex with Lawrence Moten out of Syracuse. Those Washington, D.C. guys love to wear those high white socks. Dillard, back at you. Al Dillard now with 13 in the ballgame. 20 seconds to play in the half.
I know he takes some bad shots, but I love to watch him fire away, don't you? You know what's going up.
His philosophy is the only bad shot is the shot that I don't take.
Somebody else takes, right. One-on-one. They'll spread the floor for Mucci going one-on-one here with McDaniel.
There's the crossover and the three. Putback. Auburn making all the right hustle plays. Rebounding, getting on the floor, and playing great defense.
A fitting end to the first half. 1 second left. Auburn goes to the boards. They're dominating the backboards. And they get a little stick back in the foul. I mean, this has been an incredible first half for Auburn. And you know, Arkansas at halftime, I think what you said to your kids is, look, everything went wrong for us in the first half. It can't possibly go that wrong in the second. Just come out and play hard.
Burke makes the first of two, averaging 10.5 per outing, 6.3 rebounds. He's a 67% free throw shooter. Easy for me to say, and easy for Burke to make. It has been easy as Sunday morning for the in the first 20 minutes of play. We'll take a look at Slamfest from last year at halftime. And what a first 20 minutes has been. Auburn leads big time, 58-37. Stay tuned for halftime activities after this message and a word from our ABC stations.
I didn't think I'd ever stop using Tylenol. And I didn't, really. I still use it for aches and pains and stuff like that, but for headaches, I stopped taking it. Yeah. Now I take Excedrin. Why Excedrin? Because I studied all the medical research. No, I tried Excedrin. It relieved my headaches better. Why else would anybody take it?
Excedrin, the headache medicine.
Do you know how much Pringles you've got? More from this can than you thought. Fill a bowl from a Pringles can. Got as much as this bag. Amazing, man. Can you believe how much Pringles you got? So pop the Pringles, don't stop. Get the great taste you want, not the greasy mess this bag got. Pringles, once you pop, so much more than you ever thought. You can't stop.
Fine. Oh, my son, the graduate.
So, Nikki, any plans now that high school's over?
You guys come work for me.
Not if you're smart.
You know what I think you should do? Stay close to home.
You got plenty of time to work.
Take the first thing that comes along there.
Give Anthony a call.
So what are you going to do?
Well, we're studying nuclear propulsion.
Satellite navigation.
In the Navy.
Oh, great.
Way to go, Nikki.
For more information on the high-tech skills that can help launch a career, call 1-800-USA-NAVY.
Saturday, when Tony loses a friend.
This driver was a pro.
You're saying he might have been murdered?
His investigation reveals a shocking side of the victim's life.
I don't believe you.
I know this is a nightmare. You have to call your lawyer.
An all-new Commish, Saturday on ABC.
Sunday.
What are you doing?
I'm trying to drive you to the stove.
Morgan Freeman and Academy Award winner Jessica Tandy.
Turn left. No, right.
In the Oscar-winning movie...
You're my best friend.
Driving Miss Daisy, Sunday on ABC.
To save money on your car insurance. For low-cost homeowners protection. And for a life insurance plan to protect you and your family, good news travels fast.
Car Alpha.
For auto, home, and life insurance, call the best agents in the business.
High-flying track stars Mike Powell and Mike Connolly have dominated the Foot Locker Slam Fest. Five of the first six championships were won by either Powell or Connolly. Last year, when the superstars came out to shine at the Foot Locker Slam Fest, a new format for the competition promised to add drama and excitement to the slam festivities. The previous competitions, last year's tournament culminated in a four-man final instead of two finalists dunking for the championship.
What does it mean, a final four to you, Mike?
It means you got to make all your dunks, you got to make them all count.
Well, you know, you talk about last year's format really favored you. Do you like the strategy involved this year?
Well, I think with four people, it's going to be a lot easier for me.
The change in format, along with some new faces, turn the Slam Dunk Festival upside down and produce better slams and jams. Fortunately for outfielder Kenny Lofton, he could not turn things around. The former college basketball star was eliminated in the opening round for the second year in a row. The defending champion, long jumper Mike Powell, was forced to bow out in the second round. Like Lofton, Powell had been projected to make the final four. The four finalists who rose above their rivals in the qualifying rounds displayed talents ranging from powerful athleticism to graceful creativity.
We take a look at Joyner, we're looking at power, we're looking at grace. I mean, this guy's got unbelievable upper body strength. He's a rim rattler. Mark Henry, he's gonna have to bring down the backboard. He's got one dunk, but he's a crowd favorite. He's gonna have to shake and bake him, baby. Here comes the three-time champ. He's a tremendous baseline dunker. He's a dunking machine. Herman Moore is truly a superstar athlete. Hey, this guy high jumped better than 7 feet in college.
In a moment, we'll revisit the Final Four showdown at last year's Foot Locker Slam Fest.
Just a reminder, if you're talking basketball,
give me the rock, baby. Oh, yeah.
Foot Locker knows exactly what you mean. Woo. Sort of. Yeah. Foot Locker, where it all begins.
Thank you!
About 65 miles south of the nearest stoplight, and 2 miles up in the Rocky Mountain sky, you'll find Skier's Heaven, also known as Telluride Ski Mountain, where the skiing's perfect and the views are even better. And whether you're going to extremes or just going for a lesson, don't go without your Visa card, because at Telluride Ski Mountain, they'll let you take the plunge, but they won't take American Express. Visa, it's everywhere you want to be.
As sure as the sun will rise across America, the families that travel will have one common need: to be safe. So it's no surprise that America's favorite full-size car has also been honored for safety. That's according to Prevention Magazine, which gave LeSabre the Safe Car Achievement Award in the full-size category. Buick LeSabre, the American family, family car.
In 1995, ABC's Wide World of Sports goes into high gear. The constant variety of ABC's Wide World of Sports, it just keeps getting bigger and better.
In the final round, the combined scores of the best 2 of 3 dunks determine the champion. The sentimental favorite, 370-pound wide-body Mark Henry, ran out of jet fuel in the finals. While linebacker Seth Joyner had been a bird of prey before the finals, his wings seemed to get clipped in the championship round. Three-time champion Mike Conley, renowned for his dunking as much as his world-class triple jumping, saw his quest for a fourth crown threatened by wide receiver Herman Moore.
Here he goes. The crowd is feeling the hysteria. Takes off. Oh, unbelievable, baby. Jordan is. I mean, are you serious? Look at his family. They love it. Get balls to him.
May have had a toe on the line, but that was about it. And Herman Moore has a little pressure on him. Now will he get the 10 to take the lead? A 9-9.
I can't believe it. Where's that judge?
Now Herman Moore tied for the lead. He has to respond now with the challenge. It's the first time he's really been put to the test. 9.7 will give him the championship.
Look at that baseline beauty.
But is that going to be enough? As we mentioned, a 9.7 is what he needs to take the lead.
There it is. He's the champ. A new champ is born. Herman Moore, baby.
We'll preview the field for this year's Foot Locker Slam Fest next week at halftime of college basketball on ABC Sports.
Hello and welcome to the Iceman Cooking.
Penny Hardaway
sent his recipe for black eyed peas.
All right.
These peas are pretty much like Anthony James. Pretty much enjoyed by all. Because he can do this and he can do that. You know, everybody in the league can't do that. Even got a little sugar over here. You see these black eyed peas, how well they are. Handsome, young fella, young fella.
Penny Hardaway.
It's gonna be a future all-star.
Well, man, Ice Man, you can cook it.
Just a reminder.
Corner, corner!
If you're talking basketball,
move.
Foot Locker speaks your language.
At the top, come on, meet me at the top.
Well, most of it.
Yeah.
Foot Locker, where it all begins.
Good game, kid.
I know it's a new school, honey, but you'll make lots of friends.
Attention, class.
Meet our new student, Timothy Hayes.
Lunch break, class.
Name is Timmy. It's sort of a surprise.
Hi. Timmy Hayes?
Yes?
Your pizzas are here.
Pizza Hut announces two large one-topping pan pizzas for just $13.
Anyone want some pizza?
It's a class act.
Hi.
You love the stuff we made of Pizza Hut.
Monday Television's most memorable commercials ever.
Plus mass transit using bicycles and Lynn Swann's playoff game wrap-up.
Good Morning America, Monday, here on ABC.
Monday, the question every man fears.
How do we feel about our sex lives?
An all-new comes with the shocking S word.
Stagnating.
Stagnating?
Not in a bad way.
Stagnating means rotten and smelly.
Then, Corbin Burnson's a ladies' man.
Don't touch that!
He's a real smooth operator. It's an all-new, whole new ballgame after Coach. Monday, here on ABC.
At First Alabama Bank, our strength means long-term financial security. So that when your dreams of retirement become a reality, you might miss the people you work with, but you sure won't miss the boat. First Alabama Bank, recognized as one of the strongest banks in America.
Gulf Coast Electronics, Subway, and Woe TV are giving you a chance to win big during Super Bowl 29 with the big return. Here's how to play. Register at Gulf Coast Electronics, Woe TV, or any participating Subway. Then, watch Super Bowl 29 and see if you're a winner. 10 lucky winners will receive Super Bowl prize packs. And if you're one of the two grand prize winners and a punter kickoff is returned for a touchdown, you'll win a big screen TV. The big return, only from Gulf Coast Electronics, Subway, and your Super Bowl station, Woe TV.
On the next Baywatch, a riptide in the romance.
I'm not working with him, and that's all there is to it.
Crashes in on Stephanie's sister.
Logan dumps me, and I'm still incredibly attracted to him. I mean, I don't get it.
Now, will Caroline's first day on the job...
I was watching Logan. That's why I missed the rescue.
...be Logan's last.
Your sister misses a rescue, and I get transferred for breaking up with her? Well, he won't get away with it.
On the next Baywatch.
Saturday on Woe TV.
Sports biggest show, January 29th on ABC.
College basketball. This week's nominee is Corliss Williamson of Arkansas. Last season, he led the Razorbacks to their first national title and was named MVP of the Final Four. He also became the first Arkansas sophomore to make first-team All-America and was honored as the SEC Athlete of the Year. Corliss Williamson, this week's nominee for the Van Naismith Awards, celebrating 27 years.
It is a shocker in process on the plains here in Alabama at Auburn University. The Tigers leading the Razorbacks 58-37. I'm Mark Jones along with Terry Gannon in the house. Terry, if you had told me that Auburn would be leading by this much at halftime before the game, I would have made a phone call, had you go to a clinic or something.
You're crazy.
Like that.
We're taking you out. There's no way. I mean, I am shocked. Everyone in here is shocked. And it's just a young team playing with a lot of heart right now in Arkansas, searching for some kind of chemistry. I would not want to be in the locker room with Nolan Richardson at halftime.
Arkansas, mind you, is a very good second half club. Let's take a look at the first half statistics. You look at the points, but you go down the ledger, look at the three-point shooting percentage for Auburn.
9 of 13, 69% overall. And maybe to me the biggest surprise, look at the rebounds. 19-10, Auburn leading on the glass. They are a small team. That's just desire and heart, Mark.
Arkansas has turned the ball over 9 times. And that pressure, that full court pressure by the Tigers has given them trouble, Terry, as we look at, back at some of the keys.
Auburn's handled the ball pretty well. 9 turnovers, but that's in a half where they scored 58 points. So that's not a whole lot. The heart, the emotion. 10 rebounds. That's it for Arkansas. They've allowed Auburn to shoot 69%. That just goes to being excited about playing defense and getting on the glass, Mark.
Well, Dillard starts the second half. He was the leading scorer for the Hogs. And Scotty Thurman gets the J-O-B-D-O-N-E right away. He's got the job done, and he needs more of that if they're going to be successful.
And how did they do it? They went inside, and he took it to the rack. That's what they need to do. Forget the outside shooting for a while. Go inside.
Weems back in the ballgame as well for the Auburn Tigers. He was their leading scorer. He had 15 in the half.
Now, I don't think Nolan Richardson spent a lot of time dealing with X's and O's in the locker room. And all he probably talked about was just desire, heart, wanting to win.
Razorbacks come up with a rebound. Here's Dillard. Tries to punch it inside, but it's off the leg of an Auburn player. Corey Beck back in the ballgame. He has 3 fouls. As you look at the concerned countenance of the head coach, Nolan Richardson of Arkansas.
Inside right away, Williamson backs him up. He did it early in the game. They went away from him.
Williamson comes over the back and commits the foul. He missed an easy layup. Well, that's his first personal foul.
Just does not happen very often. When he gets the ball that low in the paint, usually you can just go ahead and book it. But things are not going well and have not gone well for Arkansas.
Look at the first half scoring leaders. Dillard with 13. Had a few threes for Arkansas. Williamson with just 4. And Weems, meanwhile, the leading scorer for Auburn. Here he is with the pill. Norris. Got it. A 3-pointer for Mucci Norris. He now has 13.
The one variable in his game. And they say he's a pretty good shooter. If he can stay consistent, he is going to be a great guard for them.
Terry, looks like they're trying to post up Beck, and he does just that against Mucci Norris.
Now he took him right down to the block, and they haven't had much success going inside, but coming out in the second half, I'm sure Nolan talked about it in halftime, because that's what they've done. They've gone inside 3 straight times. Scotty Thurman with a drive to the basket, and then Corliss missed the little puppy. They go back inside again.
Dillard thought about it. Doesn't have to think about it long, folks. About a split second, he says, I think I'll take it. Dillard now with 16 in the ball game, and he notches another 3-pointer for Arkansas.
Here's the other thing that I think Arkansas is going to need to do in the second half. Maybe pick it up defensively up the court. Little trap. You know, they're not the same type team they were last year at this point. They don't give you that 40 minutes of full court pressure, but I think in the second half they're going to have to.
Not quite as quick as they were from a year ago either. Weems has it knocked out of bounds by Beck. Corey Beck, a senior, one of the seniors that will be moving on next year. But Arkansas has the cupboard well stacked. They've already recruited 6 top blue chip players.
4 JUCO transfers to fill those spots. And look at Weems. Man.
Lance Weems is on fire. He has 18.
Oh, look at a move by Corey Beck. And a little bit out of control, Mark. Gets a break.
He got bailed out. Auburn called for the block.
Could have been Corey Beck's 4th foul. He left his feet with nowhere to go. And Franklin Williams stepped in. We'll take a look. Was he there? Ooh, I don't know. It looks like he's got the feet planted at that point.
Never want to make that call, huh?
Toughest call there is.
Auburn going man on the inbound. Well, Williamson is posting up easily, but they're not getting the ball to him. And here's Flanagan the other way. 66-42. It's a special weekend here at Auburn University. They're starting up their own basketball Hall of Fame. They had some 60 or 70 former basketball players on hand, and they are witnessing a special performance right now by the Auburn Tigers. They're starting up an Auburn Basketball Letterman's Club with 80 former players, and this is what they're seeing, Terry.
Well, the fast break's been there all day for Auburn. I mean, they have beaten the Razorbacks up the floor the entire first half, and now they're doing it again in the second half. Somebody has to get back on defense once the ball goes down low or the shot's taken. And here's the post-up again. Davis trying to guard Corliss Williamson. Beck punches it in and kicks it to Scotty Thurman. Hunter. Yep, he'll hit that. And now the Hogs coming with some full court man pressure.
Now the problem is when they have gone to that pressure, Auburn has gotten easy shots at the other end. So as a coach, you say, well, we need to pressure up court, but hey, they're making us pay.
Norris, a circus shot that doesn't fall. And there's a foul on the rebound. It'll be against Auburn. And Franklin Williams got to be careful here. He kind of tossed that ball in the air. This freeze with the call. You don't want the emotion to turn the other way. Anyone over the back, there's no question. Anytime you send Dwight Stewart into the basket support, you know you created some contact.
But if you're Cliff Ellis, you're not that upset at Franklin Williams for that type of foul, as long as you're crashing the offensive boards. It's one of those hustle plays that you don't mind and you actually like if you're a coach.
No, you're right. There's no question about it. And that's how he plays. Scotty Thurman from three. And he feels it. He's got that look. Money guy, and they're going to have to switch defensive assignments. Lance Reeves can't stay with Scotty Thurman. Not quite tall enough to take away the outside shot and throw him a little bit quicker.
Down to an 18-point lead. Back man-to-man on Morris.
They're switching man-to-man. You can get some mismatches, and here's one. Yeah, see, Stewart, after the switch mark, having trouble staying with Lance Reeves, and credit Reeves with using his quickness to get the step. He didn't back up and take the three-point shot. He tried to take him to the basket.
Terry, and that foul against Stewart is exactly what I was talking about earlier. A little bit of hand-checking that the officials are really cracking down on this year, almost to a fault.
As long as they're consistent, you have no gripe as a player or a coach. Yeah, that's the one thing players and coaches want, just call it consistently.
Reeves is just blowing by Stewart. Timeout on the floor. The defending national champions trying to figure out what to do with these Tigers.
Imagine a couple of Swedish engineers have dinner with a couple of German engineers. The Swedish engineers over herring talk about safety, while the German engineers over bratwurst talk about the joy of driving. And what do you think they'd end up with? Probably the new Volvo 960. Now the only question is, who's going to pick up the tab? The new 960 from Volvo. A Consumer's Digest Best Buy.
Control is everything. Once you got it, everything else just falls in place. That's why I use this stuff, Perk Plus.
One smart shampoo, control-enhancing conditioners for hair that's easy to handle.
It just works. My hair does what I want. That's enough for me.
Perk Plus.
Straight hair, no fuss.
Imagine an antiperspirant that keeps a man feeling as clean and fresh as this all through the day. Well, this is it. Ban for Men Clear Antiperspirant. Clean and fresh because it goes on clear. And Ban for Men sets up a clear shield of protection that fights wetness and odor for a full 24 hours. Feel this clean. Feel this fresh. Try Ban for Men Clear Antiperspirant.
Sports Raycom College Basketball, brought to you by Toyota and their full line of quality cars and trucks. Toyota, I love what you do for me. Dean Witter, there are many ways to measure success. Dean Witter measures success one investor at a time. Visa, it's everywhere you want to be. And Excedrin. Excedrin, the headache medicine.
Auburn big time over the defending national champions, and those threes tell the story of the day. Arkansas with 11 three-pointers, but Auburn also with 11, and they are 11 of 16. The Razorbacks, 11 of 20.
There's the guy who's done it. Check that. Make it 12. And another three into that space.
Well, Lucci with 16, Terry.
Been incredible today.
He has never been phased, never under pressure, it seems. And there's the other man who will let him fly, Alex Dillard, for another three. Al Dillard gets off the bus shooting. Of course, everyone knows his story. Took 3 years off of school. Just worked odd jobs, grocery stores, and played basketball at night at the UAB gym. And that's really one that got away from Gene Bartow.
Played a large role last year. Struggled, as we said, first part of this year. But so on fire today.
Got his GED.
Now, Auburn's got to be careful as they try to take some patience here, take some time off the clock. Make sure you don't lose that momentum and that pace. Not a good shot that time that they got from Burke out of the corner.
Beck with the rebound. Good rebounder from the guard position. Williamson trying to steal his man inside, and we have a foul on the perimeter by Burke. Not where you want to foul Stewart. Not 30 feet from the bucket.
Yeah, but Pat Burke had those big eyes. He saw the dunk coming at the other end. He saw the wide open dunk, and he kept reaching. You're right, though. Not a smart foul. There's no way he's going to hurt you with his back to the basket that far away.
18-point lead for Auburn. Just under 15 minutes to go in the ballgame.
It's that matchup. Scotty Thurman guarded by Weems. Nice inside-outside game. Nice pass out here.
Beck drives it in and loses it. A three on nothing. Showtime.
Mark, just a little hesitation by Corey Beck. He had a wide open shot about 15 feet away and tried to get a better one.
That time the bank was closed for Beck. That time it was open.
No, but that decision, the quick decision. Arkansas, when they're playing well, you know, they don't really spend a lot of time hesitating, and they go after it, just like Dillard with his threes. And right now, there just seems to be some indecision offensively.
Defensively, Terry, there's a great battle going on between these two guys, Corey Beck and Mucci Norris. Beck trying to deny Norris the ball. And he's putting the body on him, too. Weems to the bucket. Charged. And that is his third personal foul.
You look at the other end, our slam cam, the turnover. As Beck penetrated, he had the shot right away. Slam cam to slam cam. We go the other way. And the nice, easy snowbird. We've seen it a number of times today.
The official's going to take this one back. I'm telling you, if you're Arkansas, you've got to feel like a marked team the entire year. Weems sitting down with 18 points.
That's really got to be tough if you're Nolan Richardson to keep this team focused, because they've already won a national championship. You know, fellas can say to you, well, the SEC, so what? We won a national championship. Scotty Thurman heating up here in the second half, though, getting them going.
Smooth as silk with that three-pointer, cutting it down to a 15-point lead. You can't sleep on these Razorbacks. They'll come back. McDaniel now taking Norris. And a hand check called against McDaniel. Next Saturday, ABC Sports, more college basketball for you. Pizza Hut college basketball, Vandy, Kentucky, Duke, Florida State, Texas, Oklahoma, Temple, UMass, and USC against Arizona, followed by the Fresh Look World Challenge of Champions. Christy Yamaguchi, Katarina Witt, and Midori Ito, as three of the marvelous skaters on hand. From downtown, that was only, and I say only, a two by Donald. Donald now with 11 in the ballgame.
Chris Davis guarding Corliss Williamson on the block once again. Williamson wanted the basketball.
Nice stop and go by Thurman. He's complaining for the foul. And again, another easy question by Flanagan.
Was that a replay? How many times are we going to see that happen today?
Stewart inside silences the crowd of over 10,000, but just, and I say just temporarily. 12-20 remaining in the game, 75-58, Auburn leading.
Big bucket, though. Yeah, the way he got it, too. The quick spin move down low. Nice little post up. He needs some confidence today. Missed some shots early and got into foul trouble.
DeVor Remotz getting set to check into the ballgame for Arkansas. Donald with a nice feed to Burke. Backs. 8 points for him.
So well together right now. A little give and go. The dump down low to the baseline.
McDaniel to the bucket. Garrett.
called for the travel. So far, it's all Auburn.
On average, you drive about 500 hours a year. That's like 21 straight days. Days and nights. And that's the reason for the all-new interior of the new Regal for 1995. 21 days. In most imports, that could be like a sentence. In the Buick Regal, it's more like a three-week vacation.
Bob and Judith Akers looked forward to the day they could retire to a little business by the sea.
No easy project to take on alone. Fortunately, a Dean Witter broker was there to help them chart the proper course.
Each individual's dream is unique. So, too, must be our solutions.
Now the Akers not only have a place they can call home, others can, too.
Be back at 10.
We'll leave the light on.
At Dean Witter,
we measure success one investor at a time.
You ready?
Yep.
What's this? We're playing on clay.
Right back.
It's mixed doubles.
Oh.
Outdoor court.
Is activewear becoming too specialized for you? Try Discus Athletic. Heavyweight sweats and tees. Just change your clothes once. To Discus Athletic. The way America plays.
What do the big game, the big bang, the big voice, and the big adventure have in common? Find out on the Doritos Super Bowl halftime show on ABC.
Mark Jones and Terry Gannon in Auburn, Alabama. The Tigers lead big time. Terry, someone's sleeping in the Arkansas backcourt.
What a missed shot at the other end, and then the Flanagan move at the other. Playing for the camera, and with the natural sound, you can hear how it feels to be a rip when that man brings it down. But that's happened so many times today. They're just not getting back on defense, whether it's a missed shot or a turnover. The other guard on the weak side has to get back for Arkansas.
Yeah, somebody's got to rotate. Somebody better hit the snooze switch, or maybe they've been hitting the snooze switch too much. Number one UMass playing later tonight, as is number two UConn. They are red hot. And Kansas with a slim lead over their conference rivals, Iowa State.
Straight man-to-man now for Arkansas.
Still a lot of time left. When you look at this Arkansas team, they're a good group of three-point shooters. And a foul called outside against the Razorbacks. That's Corey Beck's fourth personal foul.
And the Auburn guards have really given Arkansas fits today, whether it's on the runouts and the easy dunks, whether it's on the three-point shots, or even with their quickness in the half-court set.
They have really outquicked Arkansas, not only as a backcourt, but as a team today.
Absolutely. I mean, you think of Arkansas as a team that for 40 minutes will get after you. Last year they did that, of course, and up and down the floor, they're averaging 91 points a game this year. But this is an Auburn team that is young, is small, but they're very quick and they play hard.
Flanagan being guarded by McDaniel. Mucci missing. Arkansas with a cast of three-point shooters on the floor. Remotz, Dillard, and McDaniel can shoot it too. So time to pressure the basketball, and that's what Auburn's doing. Not letting him set up for the three. They kick it out to Remotz. Fake the pass, got an air ball. They've got numbers. Nice play by Remotz. Now Arkansas has a three-on-one.
Mark, that's
good no-call by the official.
Absolutely. It's the third time that Arkansas has had either a three-on-one break or a four-on-one, the first time that they converted today. You remember the first half, one too many passes or a bad shot. That time handled nicely, and Williamson almost threw the foul.
Take a look at this.
Yeah, Norris just stands there and takes the heat, and that's big heat from Corliss. But a good no-call. There wasn't any contact that really caused an advantage. You look at what Arkansas has done on the boards, and that has been the story for them. When they have gotten beat, UMass, Ole Miss, they've gotten beat on the board.
Jump stop and a nice jumper by Norris. Mucci Norris, the junior college transfer. It's been a long road to college for him.
was running with some rather dubious company as a youngster, straightened his life out, got into college, and his basketball career is continuing auspiciously here at Auburn University.
Got his nickname from his grandfather, who loved the Blues Brothers movie, and Minnie the Moocher, that song by Cab Calloway in that movie, and that's what he's been known as ever since.
But yeah, Minnie the Moocher, how do you get Moocher? That's kind of a combo platter of both, isn't it?
It works for him.
Grandfathers and grandparents will do that
yeah.
to you. Williamson inside to make it 79-62. Still time for the Hawks to come back.
And now the pressure, though, and this is, I think, what Nolan Richardson has to do. One of the reasons he went to the smaller lineup, to apply some pressure, but no, Auburn's guards have handled that all day long.
And how profound a statement is this? Corliss Williamson only has, and I say only, 8 points. He's the team's leading scorer, over 18 and a half per game.
Well, and especially against a lineup like Auburn has on the floor today. A 6'7 is about as tall as they get. Burke goes in at 6'10, that's it. But a turnover here, and as you say, a lot of time left in this one.
Well, tomorrow night, Terry, a special hour. Back-to-back episodes, America's Funniest Home Videos, then All My Children's 25th Anniversary Special, followed by Driving Miss Daisy. If you're Arkansas, you have to be ready to shoot, and Scotty Thurman always is, but he misses that attempt.
Yep, where are you going, Pat? It's a nice pass right to Cliff Ellis. He was open, though.
Cliff Ellis spent 10 years at Clemson, the all-time winningest coach of that school, embarking on a major rebuilding job here at Auburn.
Only coaches cats, schools with cat nicknames. You got South Alabama Jaguars, Clemson Tigers, now the Auburn Tigers. Been very consistent.
Well, he's a cat with nine lives, landing on his feet right here at Auburn. McDaniel drove to the bucket and got fouled. Wasn't sure whether that was a tattoo on his arm or scratch marks from the ferocity of today's game. Moochie checking out of the ball game. He's done a fantastic job today. He has 18 points on 7 of 10 shooting and 7 assists. Burke also taking a well-deserved rest. He didn't start today, Terry, but did a fine job coming off the bench.
Yeah, Cliff Ellis went to the smaller lineup. He put Chris Davis at 6'7 in because he was afraid that Arkansas would get up and down the floor on him, but Burke has done a nice job against Williamson. We mentioned what Corliss has not been able to do today. But you wonder when he's going to explode, you know, if they keep giving him the basketball in the second half.
Again, Arkansas almost caught sleeping. Costner was wide open for about 5 seconds. They only saw him after four. Flanagan will use a little bit of time off the clock. They can afford to be extremely patient, and they've been patient all afternoon.
Terrific poise today. Decision. That not a good one, though, that shot.
And a foul against Arkansas and Clint McDaniel. That's his third.
I just want to go back to the point that we touched on earlier a couple moments ago. Arkansas and Nolan Richardson, how difficult it must be to keep a team focused as he calls it 20 and they'll go to the sideline for a little while. He wants to talk it over, but imagine this. You've got almost everybody back, basically the same team that won a national championship. What a high that is at the end of the year. Now you tell them, all right, let's get excited. We want to win the SEC. First the division championship and then the SEC. You know, as much as you said it, your players, they're looking to march.
Yeah, they're saying, yeah, right, coach. We got you.
Exactly.
Wink, wink.
They've done that before. They won a national championship before. And so I think in the long run, he'll have them ready.
That, Terry, in addition to the fact that Nolan Richardson battles all the people outside of the team in the program who are coming up to players like Corliss Williamson and saying, hey, man, you know, you're a lottery pick. You know, you're that good. You're really a bad dude, you know. Even though he may be, it's tough to really deal with that kind of success.
Yeah.
People forget that these are only 19 and 20-year-old kids.
Just one more point on that. And if you only win by 5 or 6 points, then they want to know why you didn't win by 20. So you really can't win with all those expectations.
They trail by 15 points. Auburn has been a model of efficiency today.
Look at the ball movement. I mean, they swing it, one dribble. Oh, that's nice. I mean, great ball movement. Costner almost hesitated a little too much that time.
The exclamation point by Costner. He has 3 points. Remots got it. And now Richardson calls for some full court pressure.
Yeah, he wants Dillard to get right in Flanagan's face here.
Dillard, a great offensive player, still working on the defensive aspects of the game, and he comes up with a steal.
First bad decision we've seen him make.
Oh, the big nasty misses the big jam. But he was fouled. He just exploded to the basket.
With the left hand, going hard to the hole. And Nolan wanted the bucket. Nice pass after the steal. No dribble. He goes straight up. And he almost took Costner right through the basket with him.
He got clobbered pretty good on that field goal attempt, on the dunk attempt. Corliss Williamson struggled a few weeks ago, Terry, because of the fact that he lifted weights a little too often for Nolan Richardson's liking.
Hey, wants him to back off that a little bit. And forget about the other aspects of his game, the quickness, the finesse. I mean, he's big enough. There's no question. He didn't need to get any bigger.
He misses the second of two. He's 4-5 from the line. 81-68 advantage with 7.5 minutes to go in the game. Auburn leading Arkansas. Little half-court trap here by the Razorbacks. Weaves. He's gone cold.
Quick shot. He saw the zone. He wanted to let it fly, but ill-advised.
Speaking of letting it fly, rebound Williamson, and he's fouled by Auburn. The lead is only 13 points. As number 44, Franklin Williams, checks back into the game for Auburn. Costner will check out.
Quick shots at both ends of the floor. And we mentioned Weems against the zone. As soon as he saw that, he let fly with a three. Maybe Cliff wanted a little more patience offensively. Costner goes to the bench with four. Doesn't really hurt him, though. Inside, they've had Burke, they've had Costner. Got some big bodies.
The lead is down to 11. Scratch that. Make it 12 points. 7:14 to play. Williamson with 10 points in the ballgame. A good foul shooter. We mentioned that earlier. He's shooting just 61% from the stripe. Davis. Chris Davis has four today.
Great control. They go high, low. They exploit the traps. Auburn playing so well. And there's Corliss down low.
Thurman. Rebound Donald. It's a 3-on-2, and here comes the Moochie Shuffle. Good ball fake, and Williams is clobbered.
And if Williams doesn't reload on that one, he eats it. Corliss was coming down the floor hard. No, but Moochie under control, stopped right at the free throw line. Just what they teach you when you're a kid. You stop at the free throw line. You don't let two people guard three. He spread the floor, gave it to the right man, and they're going to the line. I mean, just good decisions all day long. And you know, I don't want to belabor the point, but Moochie Norris in his first year at Division I, I mean, he's from a junior college program. It's awfully tough to make that transition as a point guard and play well right away and be a leader, and that's what he's done.
A lot of times, as you mentioned, Terry, it takes those JC players a year, sometimes a little more, to adjust when they come into a Division I program. But those Washington, D.C. players, they have that court savvy that kind of cuts them a little more slack than most players.
A lot of great players out of D.C. And another one that maybe doesn't remind you of Moochie, but another point guard, Muggsy Bogues, actually went to Dunbar, same school as Moochie went to for 1 year.
Corey Beck back in the ball game. Dwight Stewart can fire the three. Thurman with the rebound. And the lead is down to 13.
And here comes the pressure. Every time on a made basket now, you'll see the red shirts up the floor.
Coach Richardson has a small lineup in, a speed lineup, lineup for the purposes of defense.
Now, if you don't create the turnover with that lineup, then you pay the price a little bit.
Donald misses the shot. Stewart with the board. Surprisingly, Auburn taking another quick shot.
You know what? I'm not shocked, though, because they played so well. If you're Cliff Ellis, you hate to take away that aggressiveness.
And here comes Scotty Thurman. Team Money, they call him. And Thurman sinks the three.
The lead is down to 10 now for the Tigers.
Not a bad idea for a timeout right now for Cliff Fella. And he's going to take a 20. He just got up and he's going to take a 20. Make sure that his team knows what they want to accomplish offensively, because you're in that gray area, Mark, where you don't know whether to go ahead and take that quick shot and take the first available shot and be aggressive, or to try to use some clock.
Cliff Ellis trying to calm down his troops. They led by 21 points at one point, but the lead has been shaved down to just 10 now, with 5:53 remaining in the ballgame. And that, folks, is the Cliff Dweller section. You can see the big curtain behind the basket. They put that in this year to try and create a little more intimacy between the players and the fans. And that is a student section. It's a first-come, first-served seating basis. And, Terry, I'm one never to miss the opportunity to jump on a bandwagon and grab something free. I got one of those free orange
And I'm sure
sweaters.
You didn't overlook your partner sitting next to you. I'm sure you got one for me as
I'll
well.
I'll mail you yours.
I am sure that I'll expect it, huh? Yeah, you got the Cliff Curtain and the Cliff Dwellers, and they rush in here. They fight to see who can get all of those seats.
Reams will pull it back out under heavy scrutiny and pressure from McDaniel.
Well, they've handled the pressure all day long when it has come, but now is when you really
check
have
that.
To handle it.
Garrett. The lead is down to 8. Well, it's not quite 40 minutes of you-know-what, but they're going to try and squeeze in about 5.5 minutes of it. And a foul is on Garrett.
They get Garrett on the reach, but it is awfully tough when you look up, you've got 5 minutes to go and try to defeat the defending national champions, and they bring those traps and they bring that pressure. Much different than handling the basketball in the first 5 minutes, and I'll tell you what, I thought he got him.
I thought he went
ahead and picked him clean.
I thought he picked him, picked his pocket, didn't leave many change either. Nolan Richardson's team figuring out a comeback plan. His team trails by 8. We'll return for more action between Auburn and Arkansas after this message and word from our ABC stations.
Imagine a couple of Swedish engineers have dinner with a couple of German engineers. The Swedish engineers overhearing talk about safety, while the German engineers over Bratwurst talk about the joy of driving. And what do you think they'd end up with? Probably the new Volvo 960. Now the only question is, who's going to pick up the tab? The new 960 from Volvo. A Consumer's Digest Best Buy.
This is ABC.
My husband had become unhappy and was very difficult to live with. But my psychic was so helpful. She described my husband to a T without ever speaking to him. I listened to what she had to say, and I did exactly as she advised. Now I feel like a newlywed, but with years of experience.
Her insights have done so much to improve my life and my marriage.
Why do I call my psychic? I like to win.
I call for me. It's one of the best things I do for myself.
It's wonderful. You have to try it.
Are you tired of wasting precious money and time on phony predictions from phony psychics? Our certified professional psychics are trained to help you with real solutions for love, family, job, or personal problems. We've helped thousands with every kind of problem through real human insight and absolutely accurate information. Have courage and faith.
Call now for 2 free minutes. Call 1-900-903-1242.
Only a few minutes ago, the lead was as high as 21 points for Auburn. It has been shaved down to 8 points with 5:06 remaining in the game. As Mucci Norris of Washington, D.C. and Odessa Junior College steps to the foul line for Auburn.
And the arrow does favor the Auburn Tigers. So as a player, especially a point guard, you have to know that. If you get in trouble, go ahead and hang on to the basketball.
Shooting the bonus. And he can't cash. Arkansas can cut it down to 6. Inside to Williamson. Boy, he's been out of sync all afternoon, folks.
If you just joined us, it's been that type of afternoon for Corliss Williamson.
They spent most of the game not getting him the ball. When he's gotten it, he really hasn't been able to do a whole lot with it.
And Weems got away with a walk at midcourt. And Flanagan says, thank you very much.
And if you're Arkansas right now, you have to realize there's over 4 minutes left. Now, that man, it doesn't matter because he lets it fly and he can shoot the three. But you can't panic right now.
It's down to seven with 4:23 to play. Scotty Thurman has 22 in the ballgame.
And they just do beat the 10-second count.
This is where Arkansas has won more than its fair share of games during the course of the season so far. They wear you down.
Mm-hmm. And when they get to the last 4 minutes, they believe they're going to win, and you have a doubt in your mind.
No offensive continuity on the part of Auburn right now offensively. They're not in sync. Four on the shot clock. Burke.
And they come up with the big-time play. You're right. They had no clue offensively because Arkansas took them out of their offense, but the big pass and the nice little shot.
Scotty Thurman is saying, folks, get on board. I'll take you there. The lead is down to six. Hey, they're not the defending champs for nothing. Stick around.
There are lots of reasons to buy life insurance. Here are two great ones. I'm State Farm agent Mike Foy. As the Goff family has grown, so have their life insurance needs. That's why we get together for family insurance checkups. I make sure to explain all the options, then they decide on the plan that's right for them. Ask your State Farm agent for a family insurance checkup. It's a great way to learn about life.
Wayne Winfield and Ron Williams were two of the most heavily recruited high school kids in the country. Of course, it wasn't for their game. It was for their minds. And thanks to the Navy College Fund and the Montgomery GI Bill, they have a chance to really use them because they can earn up to $30,000 for college. So, even if the NBA isn't in their future,
I guess that's game.
A BA is. For more information, call 1-800-USA-NAVY.
I know it's a new school, honey, but you'll make lots of friends.
Attention class.
Meet our new student, Timothy Hayes.
Lunch break class.
Name is Timmy. It's sort of a surprise.
Hi, Timmy Hayes?
Yes?
Your pizzas are here.
Pizza Hut announces two large one-topping pan pizzas for just $13.
Anyone want some pizza?
It's a class act.
Hi.
You love the stuff we made of Pizza Hut.
Temple takes on conference rival UMass, Duke invades Florida State, or other regional action. It's Pizza Hut College Basketball next Saturday on ABC.
Auburn by six. Moochie Norris, folks, feeds more people than a drive-through window at a fast food restaurant. This is the Pizza Hut delivery of the game, and a nice feed, maybe a deep dish by Moochie Norris to Pat Burke.
Use them all. Throw them all out there. Yeah, when everything broke down, you need a guy to take over and make a big play, and so far it's been him.
Scotty Thurman came back, made a big play, Terry, for Arkansas. Got a three-pointer at the other end to cut the lead to six. He has six three-pointers here in the second half.
After being relatively quiet in the first.
Here's your man.
Oh, man, has he been something else today?
That's the second time Beck has lost the handle. That one hurt a little bit.
Absolutely, and this is where you don't expect to see that. I mean, if being the national champion and that experience counts for anything in games right now, it's that experience to know when not to panic when you're down late in the game. And there's plenty of time right now if you're Arkansas. Just need a good, solid defensive stand here.
Second time we've seen Corey Beck hesitate and lose the handle.
Good keep away. That's exactly who you want to have the basketball, and then they draw the foul. The only problem is Arkansas commits the foul with only 13 seconds left in the shot clock.
Nolan Richardson signaling for his long-range bomber, Al Dillard. Dillard will come in for Garrett. Moochie Norris at the foul line. He is a 67% free throw shooter.
important that your point guard, a guy who handles the ball a lot, important that he be able to sink his clutch free throws. And this is a bit of an acid test for Norris. He has 21 so far today. They get 22.
Looked awfully good. The Cliff Dwellers helping him out. Staying quiet.
Arms in the air. You know, we saw his assists earlier, Terry. He has a 3-to-1 assist to turnover ratio, which is very impressive.
Yeah, anytime you're close to the 3-to-1, it's very good, especially with a young team and a first year Division I player. And that's a miss that makes it a 10-point game. Arkansas looking for the threes from Thurman, maybe, huh?
Looking for his seventh of the half. Can't find it. McDaniel. And what a big board from Flanagan. Since moving into the starting lineup, Wes Flanagan has done a tremendous job for head coach Cliff Ellis. The people here on campus at Auburn University are excited about the job that man has done so far.
Well, he spent 10 years at Clemson. He had some great players there. When you talk about Eldon Campbell and Horace Grant, won the 1990 regular season title, if there is such a thing in the ACC. They played for the tournament title, but he really had some terrific years, winningest coach in the history of Clemson, and now he's bringing that here.
Something that we talked about a little bit at the top, Terry, was the fact that Arkansas's bench is traditionally a deep bench, but the contribution of the Auburn bench today has been outstanding. When you look at guys like Chris Davis, who came off the bench today, who wasn't a starter, he's done a good job. Ray Donald has hit a few clutch shots. Mm-hmm. Costner has played well on the inside as well.
Well, the big people especially. You know, Costner and Burt came off the bench today. What they've done with Corliss Williamson has been big. But again, you've got Arkansas with Dillard, Thurman, and this man, Stewart, who can shoot the threes.
Now they've gone a little cold from the perimeter. Flanagan. Get up to the downstroke.
The beginning of the play, maybe even more impressive. Watch Wes Flanagan. He tightropes it, doesn't touch the basketball. He lets Mucci Norris get it on the sideline. And then the exclamation point at the end of the play. We've seen it before a number of times. The dunk, and this crowd at least senses the end. I'm not sure Cliff Ellis believes it yet and the team, but the crowd does.
McDaniel at the foul line makes the first of two. And should Cliff Ellis's team hang on, this might be, just might be the biggest win in recent Auburn basketball history, dating back to maybe 1988. They haven't had a winning season since 1988. They were 11-17 a year ago.
And they lost three of their top players. You talked about a Wesley Person and a Wiley and a Swinson who left here.
Thank you very much, says Pat Burke, courtesy of Weems.
Cliff Ellis and the Auburn Tigers. Let it run. You're up 13. There is the drive and the nice dish at the other end, and Burke finishes it off. Again, and we keep talking about that word, but decisions. They have made great decisions all day.
Cliff Ellis' team has responded to a daunting challenge today against the defending champs. They came into this game as heavy underdogs, but they have responded. They were poised, and they were patient all afternoon.
Cliff Ellis hasn't lit the cigar yet on the sideline, right? It's an 11-point game. You've got a minute 43 left.
They have done it via the three-pointer as well. Arkansas 97-86 with 1:43 to play. Welcome, everyone, to Auburn, Alabama. On the campus of Auburn University, I'm Mark Jones, along with Terry Gannon. Folks, let's just call today the ambush at Auburn. The Auburn Tigers came out early. They were poised, they were determined, and they clinched victory away from the Arkansas Razorbacks, the defending national champions. Terry, this game has been about three-point shooting and decision-making.
Well, Auburn came in shooting almost 70% in the first half. That's what they did. And they lit it up from three-point range. Defensively, Arkansas really struggled in the first half and really haven't been able to get it going in the second either. Right now, though, a situation. I'm not sure Cliff Ellis on the sideline for Auburn counts this one in the W column yet. Neither do the Cliff Dwellers. He's got an 11-point game with a minute 43 left. With the way Scotty Thurman can shoot the three, with the way Al Diller can shoot the three on the outside, you foul every time down right away if you're Arkansas, and you hope that they miss, you go up to the other end and fire away.
For those of you that have just joined us, Auburn went with a smaller lineup today, starting with two forwards and three guards. But it has been a total team effort. They've gotten significant contributions off the bench. Meanwhile, for Arkansas, their marquee and star player, Corliss Williamson, has been held in check.
And if you're Auburn right now, handling the basketball, you want it in the hands of either Lance Weems or Wes Flanagan. Richie Norris, only a 67% free throw shooter as a guard.
And McDaniel is whistled for the foul. That's his fifth, so he'll have to sit. Both teams in the bonus situation. And McDaniel leaves the ball game with 7 points. Got his first start today after missing two games due to a toe injury. And he played sparingly in their last game.
And there's no way around it. I mean, the guards, the backcourt for Auburn outplayed the guards for Arkansas today. Yeah. Corey Beck in foul trouble, had three fouls early on and four fouls early in this second half. And so he has been a little bit held back because of that. But the guards have played terrific basketball for the Tigers.
Williams makes the first of two. It's a 99-86 lead.
No time to waste now. Now you do have to look for the quick three.
Thurman hoists it up and shoots an air ball. They've got a foul, and they do. This is as loud as it's been in this arena in a long time. A capacity crowd of over 10,000 people has seen a basketball clinic put on by the Auburn Tigers.
Well, it's a team that certainly, when you look at what they have on paper, they're not supposed to be able to do this. I mean, they're doing this with heart, with hustle, playing hard, and they shot the ball so well. But they're not supposed to do this against Arkansas.
And that is his fifth. He will have to leave. The senior leaves with 4 points.
Credit Corey Beck. After making the foul, committing the foul, he went right after Franklin Williams, picked him up and said, look, it was just one of those things. I got to put you on the free throw line. But what a frustrating afternoon it has been for Arkansas all the way around. I mean, from cap to buzzer at both ends of the floor, Auburn has just been on fire today.
Terry, there's going to be certain questions raised about this Arkansas squad now. It's the second time in conference play that they have been ambushed on the road. They lost earlier this season at Ole Miss, a game where they came out, gave a lot of effort, but the legs weren't there. So, and you know, people are going to say it's an excuse, but they were kind of jet lagged from their long trip back from Hawaii. How does Nolan Richardson answer the critics after this loss?
I don't think he tries, to be honest with you. I think he focuses on his team. I think he uses this with his team. We talked about it earlier. It's awfully tough to get your team focused and to have them play with emotion when they won a national championship, when they're looking at March. There's no way around it. You use this to motivate your players. They now know any timeout, they can get beaten like this.
As Mucci Norris dribbles over to our table, gave us a little shuffle. The Cliff Dwellers, they love it too. You sense that this is the start of something very, very positive at Auburn. It's the type of game, the type of victory that can really turn a season around.
Start of a heck of a weekend here, I'm sure, too, on campus. All the recruits in town, and yep. the women's team has a big game against Tennessee afterwards.
Auburn with 102 points on the scoreboard. A dollar two. Terry Gannon against the defending champs Arkansas.
It's amazing.
One thing for Auburn to score 102 points against Alabama State, which they did earlier this year, but to score it against this team, a great defensive team, is another matter. Remus. Possession Auburn.
Let's go back to the doubts about Arkansas for a moment, though. They started the year with the loss to UMass, where UMass just blew them out of the gym. They won 11 in a row and really felt they had it going again. And then they get beat by Ole Miss, but you say, okay, the Hawaii trip took a lot out of them. This is one where you do go back to the drawing board and you say, all right, we need to do specific things to get better. What are they now? We know for certain we're not playing like we can.
Well, one thing is for sure. Nolan Richardson will have his team's attention in practice all week long. Dillard with half a minute to go.
And, Mark, I think the first thing they need to do is really have an idea offensively what they want to get done and where they want to start. And I think it's got to start with Corliss Williamson. They went away from him early in this game when they really had an advantage inside. They got to make sure he's the center of this team.
Weems, the three-point assassin, has done a fine job. And it's Mucci time now, folks. Gotta be ready when he's got the rock in his hands. Cliff Ellis acknowledging the Cliff Dwellers for a job well done. They drew on the strength of that student section. One of the rebuilding job, the reconstruction job here at Auburn is complete.
Well, the foundation is laid. There's no question.
They at least put one brick down. Cook puts this one down.